As I mentioned earlier, Quicksilver was done in the early 80s, and here is a sketch reproduced from their paper. Interesting thing that you notice is that this sketch is very similar to what I showed you as the current structure of networked operating systems in the earlier panel. It's a microkernel-based design, and Quicksilver was the same vintage as Mark from CMU. And having seen the structure of operating systems in earlier lessons, this picture should be very familiar to you, that all the system services are provided above the microkernel, and the microkernel is only responsible for process management, IPC, and machine control. And all of the system services, such as window manager, file system, virtual memory, and communication, all of them sit above the microkernel, and the system services are implemented as server processes. Now, the late 80s was an exciting time for distributed systems. There were no laptops in that time. We were moving from CRT terminals, cathode ray terminals, connected to a mainframe, to the era of office workstations, what we routinely call as desktops these days. Quicksilver was conceived as a workstation operating system. And the ideas that are enshrined in the Quicksilver operating system predates or were concurrent with many things that we take for granted today, such as network file system, remote procedure call, the internet, the World Wide Web, and so on. What sets Quicksilver apart from the competition at that time were new services such as Window Manager for managing the real estate on the workstation screen and how it should be integrated into the operating system as a whole. Services that may not be available in the workstation itself. For example, a file server, maybe remote. So integrating communication into the design of the operating system was key. And services that are within a workstation and across workstation on the network in the distributed system need to recover from failures. Rather than ad hoc mechanism for each server to recover from such failures, Quicksilver was the first to propose transaction as a unifying concept for recovery management of the servers. It was the first operating system to propose transactions in operating systems. And that's the reason you see Transaction Manager as part of the service provided by the operating system. A quick personal note, I was a graduate student at University of Wisconsin-Madison in the early 80s and spent a year in IBM research working with the group that conceived and designed this Quicksilver operating system. My dissertation research, which was on hardware support for inter-process communication, used as an experimental platform a precursor to the Quicksilver operating system, which was called 925. Recall what I told you earlier, that Quicksilver was intended as a workstation operating system, and 925 was the name of the operating system that was a precursor to Quicksilver. And as you can imagine, this is a pun on office workstation, 9 to 5. That was the name given to internally to the precursor of the Quicksilver operating system.